I was given the name of Dechgash by Achilles, which means good eagle, lucky eagle, fortunate eagle, eagle that has a good life. It means all those things. As the contrary warrior, I don't go the same route as everyone else. Now that I'm 80 years old, I can look back on a remarkable journey of life. When Alcatraz was declared surplus property, I said, here's an opportunity to do something on another level. So we started coming up with concepts. How, if we took that island, had the island, what could we do with it? November 9th, 1969, I had arranged for 5 boats to take a whole group of us out the island. I had all the United Council members who had tribal outfits, put them on. We want to look Indianish. This is an Indian event, and we got to look Indian out there. And when we got to the north side, we heard a splash in the water. Richard Oakes dove overboard and started swimming toward the island, even with logging boots on. The Indians held the island of Alcatraz for 19 months. And in the course of 19 months, we changed the course and direction of history. Now, we hear all kinds of stories about boarding schools destroying culture, tradition, and language of the children. By 1935, under the Collier administration, it was okay to be Indian. One language that was forbidden, strictly forbidden, was profanity. No cussing. We would hurl insults against each other, but not cuss you out. The Sioux would call us Chippewa boys rabbit chokers. We would call them dog eaters. Well, that's the insult kind of thing. But that was as far as it went. Wow, we're going to go to the Vatican. So here we go already again. The Pope raises his hand to me. And okay, so I have this beautiful silver and turquoise ring. I raised my hand to him. There was a gasp in the Vatican, the cardinals, the bishops, the aides. Oh my God, there's going to be an international incident between His Holiness and the Indian. I'm in violation of federal law right now. I don't have a permit to possess these feathers. The law also states we cannot buy, sell, or trade eagle feathers, which again is another prohibition that is affecting our traditional powwows and ceremonies to this very day, because Indians are still being arrested for providing eagle feathers to other Indians. I know I'm the only Indian on this reservation who will attempt anything like this. So it is, in fact, a dying art form. So I wrote my first book about Alcatraz, and I followed that up with a second book, Heart of the Rock, The Indian Invasion of Alcatraz. And this is the kind of experience that I write about because it's never documented anywhere else, because no other author of a boarding school book ever lived or had the boarding school experience as I have. When you're working on the ceremonial things, be of good heart, good mind, and good body. So I'm sitting here, and I won't anything upset me. Even if I should drop the pipe on the concrete floor and break it, I won't get upset. So there you go, just like that. There's no factory stuff here. It's obvious, you know. It's all handmade. You might call it labor intensive. But if you enjoy what you're doing, it's not work.
I believe that all life revolves around the sacred circle. And according to tribal legends, the 7 grandfathers gave our people special gifts to guide us in a proper way of life. The gift of love, wisdom, respect, bravery, truth, compassion, and humility.